Thank you. Aye, Miss Buttercup, and well called, for you're the rosiest and the roundest and the reddest beauty in all Spithead.
Aye.
Red am I, and round, and rosy. My dear, for I have dissembled well. But hark ye, my merry friend, hast ever thought that beneath a gay and frivolous exterior there may lurk a cankerworm which is slowly but surely eating its way into one's very heart?
Why, nay, my lass, I can't say I've ever thought that.
I've thought it often.
Yes, you look like it. What's the matter with the man? Isn't he well?
Don't take any heed of him, miss. That's only poor Dick Deadeye.
I say, it's a beast of a name, ain't it? Dick Deadeye.
It's not a nice name.
I'm ugly too, ain't I?
You are certainly plain.
And I'm three-cornered too, ain't I?
Well, you are rather triangular.
There. I'm ugly. And you hate me for it. Well, you all hate me, don't you?
We do!
Well, Dick, we wouldn't go for to hurt any fellow creature's feelings. But you can't expect a fellow with a name like Dick Deadeye to be a popular character now, can you?
No.
It's asking too much, isn't it?
It is. From such a face and form as mine, the noblest sentiments sound like the black utterances of a deprived imagination. It's human nature. I'm resigned.
But tell me, who's the youth with faltering feet, with difficulty bearing on his course?
That is the smartest lad in all the fleet, Rafe Rackstraw.
And all is
I'm too high. Our worthy captain's child won't have nothing to say to a poor chap like you. Will she, lads?
No. Captain's daughters don't marry poor man's hands.
Did I? These sentiments of yours are a disgrace to our common nature.
But it is a strange anomaly that the daughter of a man who hails from the quarterdeck may not love another who lays out on the foreyard. For a man is but a man, whether he hangs his flag on the main truck or his slacks on the main deck.
Aye.
You know, Dick, I don't want to press hardly upon you, but such revolutionary sentiments as you utter are enough to make any honest sailor shudder.
Lads, our gallant captain has come on deck. Let us greet him as so brave an officer and so gallant a seaman deserves.
My gallant crew, good morning.
Sir, good morning.
I hope you're all quite well.
Quite well, and you, sir?
I am in reasonable health, and happy to meet you all once more.
You do us proud, sir.
I am the captain of the Pinafore.
And right good captain, too.
You're very, very good at being understood. I command the right good.
Love.
and pleasing person.
Thoughtful father.